But I want to talk to you today on the subject, can anger strengthen relationships? Kind of a strange title for a sermon. Some of people would automatically say there's absolutely no way that's going to happen. Others may be intrigued and think, you know, maybe it is possible for that to happen. But usually when we think of anger, what do we think of? We don't think of gain. We think of pain, right? We don't think about being strengthened. We think about disappointment, defeat, discouragement. But I honestly believe that anger and conflict, if it's handled properly, right? If it's handled properly, it can actually build a bridge and can cause our relationships to be strengthened. And, of course, we already know that anger can destroy relationships. How many of you have ever seen a relationship destroyed because of anger? Sure, a lot of damage can be done. And I really like the Living Bible paraphrase. I know it's a paraphrase, but I like to read it for you today. Proverbs 11:29, it says this, "The fool who provokes his family to anger and resentment will finally have nothing left." Wow, there's a lot of truth in that scripture. And we know that in almost every relationship that you have, at some point, there'll probably be anger. Am I right? You choose the relationship with your spouse, with your parent, with a child, with a coworker, neighbor, friend, whoever it is. There's going to be a moment of anger probably take place. And while we would love for there to always be peace, typically when there's anger or confrontation that takes place or conflict, we kind of feel like the peace is taken away from us. Internally, we lose our inner peace, right? We're all emotionally upset. Externally, there may be the silent treatment that hangs like a giant wall or you know, shouting and these types of things. But the truth is, the reality is that everybody faces moments of anger and conflict, because we're all humans, right? And so maybe you're here today and you say, well, I'm a Christian, I don't get angry. You know, Christians that are spiritual don't get angry, they get grieved in their spirit. No, you get angry, right? People get angry. But let me just say this, Jesus got angry. Did you know that? The scripture records Jesus being angry. Now, Jesus sometimes started conflicts. He avoided conflict. He resolved conflict. But yet, the amazing thing about Jesus was that all through his life and ministry, he was very consistent, and he never, ever sinned. And so I want to ask you today a question as we begin. Is your character consistent when anger and conflict happen? Do your family and friends kind of expect of you? What do they expect of you in the midst of conflict and anger? Because the truth is, everybody's got triggers, right? How many know what triggers are? You know, that's what makes you upset and angry. You know, for some people it's traffic. For others it's the IRS. For others it's their ex-wife or their ex-husband or President Obama or President Trump, whoever it is. You know, they have a trigger that goes along with that. And typically in a room like this one, there's going to be two types of people, right? There are those who, when they get angry and experience conflict, they're what I want to call the exploders, right? They just explode. They get tense. They lash out. They say things. They dominate. In a sense, they go on the attack. They're exploders. And then there's the imploders, okay? These are the people who would rather bury it then deal with it. Better not to say anything, you know, don't want to cause any trouble. And so what they do, they stuff it down on the inside. So let me ask you as we begin, what are you? You don't have to, you can write it down, but think about it. Are you an exploder or are you an imploder? And a lot of times imploders, they think, well, you know, I'm more spiritual. I'm a lot better than the exploders, you know, because, you know, at least I don't, you know, spread verbal shrapnel all over everybody and nobody gets wounded from me. But actually, sometimes the exploders say, well, at least I got it out. I'm all over with it. But actually, that's not true. Did you realize that? That's not true, because the more you lash out in anger in a powerful way and you not control it well, what happens is you can actually get addicted to that endorphin rush that gives you a sense of power. Did you know that? But so that doesn't really work. The more you rage, the more you want to rage. But let me tell you, stuffing it down, that doesn't work either. How many of you realize that? It's because it's like you're burying toxic waste. It's going to leak. And hidden anger is going to poison your body. That's why a lot of people have headaches and stomach problems and sleep disorders, because they keep putting it all down on the inside. And hidden anger can poison your attitude, make you very cynical, short-tempered, bitter, depressed. Hidden anger can poison your relationships. It can even make you difficult to be around. Hidden anger can poison even your faith. And some of you might be thinking, well, I am just who I am. And the truth is, most of us handle anger the way we learned it in our family system. How many of you understand that, right? You say, well, my daddy was an exploder, my mama was an exploder, my grandpa was, and so that's the way I react to it. But how many of you know that we're not born with predisposition genes that we automatically have to do that? Am I right? We can learn a different way to handle that. And so how many of you said, I'd really like to have peace in my life? Even if there's anger and conflict, and especially when there is anger and conflict, what do I do? I've got a little peace plan for you, a little acrostic for you.